Move over, popcorn balls, because today we're making deep fried macaroni and cheese balls. That's, you know, looking good enough. Just gonna rub this aluminum foil down with some butter. Now we will form our ball. We actually have enough for a backup just in case that's needed. It wouldn't be a bad idea to batter them. It's not so much of a ball as it is, you know, just a big lump of stuff. You gotta be gentle with it. You don't want it to fall apart in your hands. And kerplunk, it's so heavy. It's laborious. We're way past the danger zone. We gotta get this thing frying. And we're gonna start with the battered one. Here we go. Yeah, that's looking dangerous. I don't know how to tell that it's done, but we're just gonna say that it is. All right, now we're gonna put our unbattered mac and cheese in it. Oh my God. It didn't do quite as well. You have two choices in front of you, the battered and the unbattered mac and cheese. It seems pretty obvious which one's gonna be the winner, but you know, I have been wrong before. Oh, now that looks like a big bundle of wonderful right there. Let's give it a try. It's really good. You smother the whole thing with cheese sauce and you're in business. This one, on the other hand, we you know, screwed the pooch pretty good on that. I'll just try a little bit of the outside. Surprisingly, this one's not crispy at all. It's all very gummy and chewy. The choice is pretty clear here. This one's the winner. I'm gonna have to give the deep fried mac and cheese ball a 4 out of 5.
Bop, 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 bop.